we were missing, England were missing some of their top players, but who are we starting off with? VA and Sakes?
Yeah, right. I had Sakes in my pool. I played against him.
Yep.
And by the looks of it, they send him in just because it's Fox, and there's no real bad matchup for Fox.
Nope.
And neither is Peach.
It's a good strategy for crew battles, sending your fast faller, sending that Fox. Feel him out a little bit. But right now, VA with the chain grabs.
Yeah, he's definitely way too consistent at them to drop any of these.
He is one of the top players in Europe right now, and he is looking very comfortable. Sakes yesterday, obviously, in this, the reverse match of this, did destroy Jelly, but this is a different breed of player right here, and here we go again with the chain grabs.
Sure.
You hear?
Yeah, chance.
You can hear the chance. You can hear the chance. He's not going to drop these. Ooh,
oh,
he does get out.
Actually is. Well, he does get the nair and a happy turnip on top of it.
Two stock lead, that is healthy right now. I don't know why they struck to FD. Sakes must have been feeling very comfortable. Or confident even. Ooh.
And there, Fox is off stage.
You can feel.
That's a dead animal right there.
Yep. You can feel the confidence VA has.
Now if you can at least take one stock, that would already be a kind of decent trade. I mean, they sent him in for that very reason.
I think VA is looking to close this out with a big four stock lead to go into this, to the rest of this crew battle.
That's quite possible.
You can hear the crowd. You can hear them going. They won that four stock. That's how you do it. That was.
And a four stock to start off this crew battle.
That was emphatic. That was nasty.
Now let's talk counter picks for this, because they aren't too obvious. We could go for the Peach Ditto if Trifasia goes in.
Yep.
Or we could have Over, one of their strongest players, go in with that Sheik, probably. Oh, wait.
Slido. There we go. There we go.
And then there's Scam.
Who does Scam
K-12
play again?
I'm not even sure.
I can't remember from yesterday.
I know that K-12 is playing Samus, but. Or maybe doesn't, we don't know.
Well, we know that Over and Triff, as like they're the two dominant ones. I don't think they'll want to send them in, but they might have to. And I think if they do, I reckon it'll be Triff. Because they're going to want to hang on to Over for as long as possible. But
yeah, I think so too.
But Peach Ditto is a battle of attrition.
But it has happened before, and I'm not sure how much experience Trifasia has in a Peach Ditto.
It's
a really weird matchup.
I think he has quite a bit. I mean, I commentated back in Beast 4, and they had like two sets best of five Peach Dittos, and they were so tight, but obviously they decided to send in Over Triforce. VA did really well against them yesterday, and I don't know, Peach?
I mean, Over isn't easy to counter as well, so...
Yep. But they had to do a big move right here, Spain, because
four
stocks down, VA is feeling hot. He took like five stocks against France. He's feeling good.
Already catching that first turn in. Doesn't fall for the down smash. But this time he does. Another one.
These down smashes.
You must get tired of it. At some point.
So what do you think the reasoning behind this stage was? Do you think he wanted less space to work with for the Peach, or it's just the lower boundaries? Oh,
I'm not really sure.
VA,
I mean, the side part bombs allow Sheik to recover on top of them instead of always having to go on stage, which Peach can probably cover pretty well. But on the other hand,
that was a good
probably the fast kills with the fair because of the tight blast zones too.
Yep. As you can see there, he did get a bear kill pretty early for Peach, you know? It's like, Peach can live for a long time.
For sure.
Can VA get this edge guard? He goes low, uses
Interesting
Randall.
Interesting recovery, using Randall to his advantage.
Ooh! That's uncharacteristic by Over Triforce right there. Maybe he's feeling a bit nervous. He's not ready to carry the weight of Spain on his shoulders.
Obviously UK, or England I should say, with a lot of momentum coming into this.
Yep.
From the battle against France.
Ooh, that was very nice though. That was tricky.
That was super clean.
That was so tricky by Overdrive was. Beer holding it in there.
Nice.
He's doing his thing. He's really looking for the heavy damage. He's looking to catch over. Alright, VA has a little bit of a history of choking when the pressure gets on him. So let's hope he can hang in there.
I mean, he already took 4 stocks, so...
Yeah, he's done his job. He's done his job. Anything more right now for VA is just a bonus. What can Overdrivers do? Gets him with the up B. It's not Smash 4. Alright.
And VA with his last stock.
Can he get the edge guard?
This should be relatively easy.
See, he keeps his bomb though.
No, this just channeled so much hype, but nothing happened.
He went for the hard read there. I thought he would roll into it. Can Robbie pull this off?
Good tech chase there.
That was so nice.
He wisely waited for that down smash to happen so he could punish afterwards.
A lot of newer players would have just jumped straight into that, taking a hell of a lot of damage. Can Over take the stock right here? Because he really
has
to.
Such a good decision.
For Spain to stand any sort of a chance in this crew battle, he has to win this match. But it's not looking good right now. Forces on stage.
I mean, at this high percentage, Jeff Fair really works well.
Randall helping everybody out. Ah!
There's the victory for Overdrive Wolves.
Alright, so 3 stocks though. He took a straight 3 stocks. Over has 1 to work with, and the big boys, Prof and Fuzzy, are still to play.
So, you obviously know the English crew the best.
Oh.
Who would you send in? Oh, they already made up their minds.
I think if they're being super serious, they would send in Prof, and they definitely have. They're being super serious. They want to get this over with. They want to move on to Germany. Exactly. They want. Who else have Spain got? Just Scam.
Scam K-12. and K12 and 1 stock of Over and Trifasia.
All right.
Now, just the roster being bigger obviously is an advantage in itself, in as that you can counter pick much more, like we saw with that Bowser.
It's a good lead. It's a healthy lead for Prof. Over Triforce was at the most recent weekly or last 2 tournaments that we've had in England, and I believe Prof double 3-0'd him in losers and winners. So I feel like he'll be super confident going into this. But you never know. Over Triforce has been around for a while. He's been a top player for a while. He needs to take the reins and carry Spain.
And this is already a really good job, right?
That snipe, that was such a nice play.
Good follow up. Can he connect the second one? No, he can't.
I think Prof trying to be a little bit more patient there. He doesn't want to lose his stocks as quickly as then. Goes for a back throw, that's different. He's not even going to go to the ledge. Stage is transforming and he doesn't need to go to the ledge. He can chill. I hate Pokemon.
I tend to agree.
This is... just stalls all the fun. Alright.
A little bit of a risky decision there by Over.
He wants to get in space. Then again,
on this transformation, at least he can tech at the tree. So maybe that wasn't even the worst decision. It's working out fine for him. He gets that up tilt. Can't connect anything on the platform though. And is that just going to be an up tilt and that's it? That's it.
Up tilt. Up tilt's so strong.
Yeah. Really high kill potential.
Professor Pro with 3 stocks still. So. Spain are really up against it now. Their best player is gone, and they have 3 people left. Who are they sending in? Who do you think they would send in? I think they would have to do Triff. I think anyone else who comes in right now is going to do more damage than good.
I don't know
good.
How good Prof is in the Samus matchup. Prof, because they are sending on K-12.
Prof used to play Samus, so
he knows
a little bit about Samus. Definitely does. But I like it. It's different. Samus is an awkward matchup and can, like, really stop momentum. Like, if you go from playing, like, someone you're used to playing against and then you have to play a Samus and you have to think a little bit differently, changes it up. But let's see what K-12 can do right now.
Ooh, that was actually a really...
Ooh!
Wow. I was going to say it was really smart to go for the down throw instead of the usual up throw, yep. Because you can't get that up air follow-up, but instead you can at least go for tech chases and just take the chance.
Exactly, and he missed the tech there. Alright, both players trying to fight out for stage control right now. K-12 doing a good job keeping their Prof on the ropes. I think it's a little bit of a mistake there, and each little mistake is so costly. Boom!
Wave shine on smash, that's how you do it.
Simple. Keep it simple, people. Learn them fundamentals. He's just chasing them with these up airs right now. He's feeling aggressive, you can tell.
Samus' priorities in a downward angle aren't that good, so every time Prof gets him up there, it's actually really easy for him to win the trades.
Ooh, that was a good edge guard.
That was really
up tilt.
Good.
Sometimes you often forget that Samus has that quick little up tilt. Oh.
I was waiting to see the shine on that. That would have been such a hard read.
No, I thought he was coming. This. Ooh, K-12! That was
phenomenal play there.
That was silky! He's feeling himself right now. What can Prof do? K-12 really holding it down for Spain right now. If he can take the stock without losing this one, oh.
This was such an important stock.
Said that a bit too soon. I think he's got Prof figured out a little bit at the moment.
Yeah,
Prof can't find a way in.
His spacing is really on point.
He usually finds a way in much easier, but the spacing right now by K-12. Using the missiles, getting them out. Alright, Prof is fine taking the center stage right now. He'll chase K-12 down as much as
one
he can.
One thing I really like about K-12 Samus is how he utilizes the dash attack, especially at this percentage, because it channels Fox upwards and sets up for a really nice snare and an offstage situation. But this
the
up smash
Phantom.
Will definitely kill him.
The Phantom helping him out a little bit there. Alright. This time he does manage to get the tech off the down throw. Crowd chant and one more stock. Ooh, good movement there. Can he get this edge guard? No, Prof found his way back onto the stage. Both players looking a little bit slower than they were before, maybe a little bit nervous. Ooh. They're really trying to feel each other out right now, like, everyone's just... Can he get this edge guard? K-12, back air.
Good job.
Good DI by Prof there. Makes it back on right now. K-12's in trouble, but Samus has all the recovery in the world. Good grab. Big neutral air. He's living though. The DI.
The DI was real on that one.
Oh no. Ooh. Ooh. He read it.
He
just read it.
He gets the tech chase he needs. Oh, his set gets hit by that dash attack, and that is gonna kill. This was such an important stock to take for K-12 and for Spain, for that matter.
Wave dash back.
Dash attack.
Damn. All right. K-12.
So Prof is out. MVA is out for the British team.
So that's two of the big hitters, and I think if they're I think Fuzziness should stay in wait right now. But I wonder who they'll throw
in. I would agree. I would keep Fuzziness for Trifasia.
Definitely. K-12 did so well there. I think, what, Prof had 3 stocks going into that? And I mean, to not get beat by the 4th best in Europe, supposedly. Definitely. A little bit biased. Jelly stepping up again, and I'm not sure the England cap is unanimous in this. I wonder how drunk he is. That's great. He's chugging a beer before he decides to play. I don't know.
Maybe he's going to calm down his nerves.
Maybe. But you might go one too many. From an English standpoint, against the Samus, I don't know who would go in there. Like, I know quite a few of our boys don't like these weird matchups. Jelly might be the man for it.
I mean, we
fair.
Could do it the other way around. Like, Alpha Dash wouldn't make sense, for example.
Alpha Dash definitely wouldn't make sense. R23, I would love to see him going, but I don't think he will. Yeah, it's definitely looking like Jelly right now. I don't think he should, though. But we'll see. He's usually very good at these weird type of matchups. Like, that most of the UK have problems with. But we'll see what happens.
It's always good to have someone like that on your crew. Someone who can just take out the wild cards on the enemy team.
It's true.
So they're actually sending in Fuzziness by the looks of it.
Changed it up. Fuzziness.
So I wonder if Fuzziness is just going to go Fox? Probably.
Yeah. I have no idea.
He does have that Falcon as a backup against Samus. That might work.
I would assume he would be doing Falcon. Because
it works well against Samus, and it also works well against Trifasia, who's probably coming
exactly.
on next.
But then again, so does Fox.
At least against the Peach. I'm not so sure about the Samus. I think it's a really weird matchup for Fox.
It's not too bad, people.
It's definitely winnable.
Ladies and
overall,
gentlemen.
Pretty balanced. And I see the Falcon coming in.
He's definitely going Falcon. Fuzziness doing all or nothing right now. He wants to ride the hype train. He wants to hear that crowd roar. He wants to see the knees, them electrical knees. All right. This is a big play. This is a big decision for Team England. I still want to call them Team UK. We're usually Team UK. It makes no sense.
I make that mistake so often today.
Anyways, this is a big play because if this backfires, it could be downhill. But wrong stage? Yeah, wrong stage. Where do you think they went to? You're betting, man. It's got to be Battlefield, right? Unless they want something special like Dreamland. I reckon keep it safe, keep it simple.
I mean, I could also understand Pokemon Stadium.
That's true.
Because
Falcons like a little bit of Pokemon Stadium, don't they?
I think Pokemon Stadium would make a lot of sense, but what we're seeing right now is Battlefield.
Yep, straight out Battlefield. Yeah, I think against the Samus, you definitely don't want to go for Pokemon Stadium because the missiles.
For sure.
They can do so many missiles. It's so annoying. Shoutouts to you, Samus mains. Keep doing your thing. Alright. What we want to see right here, from the biased UK standpoint, is Fuzzy just knee, stomp, get this over and done with. He needs to be patient though. K-12, definitely tricky, as we saw in the last match. Knows his stuff. Ooh! Alright, only gets one knee out of it.
It's really interesting to see him go for those dash attacks so often. Because so far they haven't been working out for him.
No.
But he trusts them. Maybe.
I mean, it could work for a little bit. But I mean, you said, like, by the looks of it,
he's overdone it by now.
Yeah. Ooh!
And he pays for it with a knee and a taunt to the face.
He got stuck on that platform, and Fuzzy was just like, I'm gonna see you. You're about to drop through, and I'm gonna knee you. Boom. Into the taunt. Fuzzy loves it. Whenever he's playing Cruz or he's got the team, the English crowd behind his back, Fuzzy usually steps up a notch. It's so quality to see. And no surprise.
I love Full Metal so much.
No surprise. We've got Triff coming in. So we're about to have Peach versus Falcon. Probably Dreamland. What do you reckon? Dreamland?
Probably Dreamland.
Probably. Yeah, because Fuzzy will ban FOD. Straight up. No nonsense.
And right. Why wouldn't you?
Obviously.
I mean, Dreamland is the much better choice for Falcon, obviously, because his combo game still works really well on Dreamland and his movement as well.
Ooh.
Oh, we're actually going to FOD.
Oh, yeah, that is true. Fuzzy actually likes this stage, whereas most Falcons, you know.
There's one in a million Falcon mains who actually counterpick to FOD.
But as we know right now, 8 stocks for the Spanish team, 12 for Team UK, or Team England. Ooh!
What a knee!
Stomp to reverse knee, he almost gets killed.
Fuzziness is feeling himself.
Fuzziness right, ooh, that was very nice back air.
Fasia fell right for it.
Fuzziness saying right now, I might have been speedrunning for a while, I might have been out of this scene, but I can come in and I can body some people.
I mean, technically Captain Falcon is a speedrunner as well, so maybe that kind of works in his favor.
I hope he managed to eat this time. Yesterday, he got bopped yesterday on stream.
Oh no.
All right, managed to get away. All right, that
really
was a
nice
good
patience there by Triff Asia.
Very patient.
Can't deny that.
Nice neutral air. Neutral air so quick by Pete.
Only one hit, and that's the problem about FOD for Captain Falcon. His areas are just gonna get interrupted by those platforms.
The platforms just make the movement so much harder, so much more difficult. There's nothing Fuzzy can't deal with. Both players being real patient. Like, no one wants to make a mistake right now. Everyone understands the importance of this match right here. Seemed like a little bit of a mess up there. Oh, gets the grab. That's what we're looking for, people. We're looking for these Falcon grabs.
Oh, the power shield.
Ooh, mistake there by Fuzzy. All right, he's down to 2 stocks, and Triff is at 3. They're tied.
This good
the next stock
game
is going to be a very important stock right here.
Catches him mid-air. Doesn't connect into anything. Now he's got the nair, and he keeps center stage. And as I say that, he actually drops it.
It's a good back air by Fuzzy. Manages to get past Triff's edge guard. Ooh, goes for a hard read. Goes for another up
second one.
Ooh, good back.
Oh! Wow! That was incredible.
Ooh. Catches the turnip. Throws it straight back in his face. But Triff isn't phased. Triff comes straight back on, gets rid of Fuzzy. And he's like, I'm maintaining my lead right here because I need to do this for my country. I need to do this for the Spanish people. Fuzzy looking for that center stage. Makes it back. Very risky going on the ledge like that.
Triff Asia keeping so much control right now.
He's like, I can't believe
guess that
you let me go
well
to the
that
stage.
Should be
that's
an
what
easy
saying
edge guard. And
oh,
there we
that
go
was very nice. All right.
Game.
Goku's
Triff
gone.
Takes it.
And Team England on the squad, on the bench right now, not too happy with Fuzziness' performance, but that was so nice. Right at the beginning with that reverse knee. Didn't get the kill, but it was so nice. All right. So 8 stocks to 6 stocks, and now there's going to be some hard thought. Because the big thing is, no offense to Scam, don't really know him, don't know how good this dude is.
I know what you mean. I know
right?
what you mean.
And from what I've heard, after talking to like a martyr and stuff, like is not the one that they should be worrying about. Right now, it's who is going to have the mental ability, the calmness,
to just
and the
take
skills
those two stocks off of Triff Asia.
Off of Triff, and then bring it home for Team England. Triff is going to be feeling himself right now. He's come in. He's played it smart. He's played it patient.
Let's talk matchups for a bit, because I know how Destgazer plays, but
yes.
I don't know how he plays against Peach. Does he have a lot of experience against, say, Vanity Angel?
I'm going to say he probably has quite a bit of experience, but at the same time, like him and his crew, Tesco crew, they're all about the fast fallers. If you're not playing a fast faller, you ain't playing this game right. That's what their philosophy is, right? So I don't think he'd be the one to be thrown in there. I feel like Jelly will be the most confident, but the most risky at the same time. But I don't know, against the Peach, it's difficult. It's difficult. I personally would want to see R23. He's on a hot streak right now. He's very composed, and he took a couple of games the other day off some really top European players. He took game off over Triforce. He drove Eichel into the edge in a money match. He's really hot. He's been playing well today.
Sounds good.
But Jelly's going in with Mario.
I actually see Jelly.
Okay.
Who is Mario?
Jelly is the Mario main of the UK. The Mario main maybe of Europe. Shout out to Sim Shady. I know he's there somewhere. So he's going to be feeling comfortable.
And Slim Shady's going to want to watch this.
Obviously, these two teamed earlier, Slim Shady and Jelly. But right now, Triff, Jelly, 4 stocks to 2. Spain, England, 6 stocks to 8. It's tight. Alright, what you'll see with Jelly's.
Lots of upbeats.
He loves his upbeats.
And also probably a lot of capes against the turnip game to counter that, just straight up.
What I'll tell you is Jelly is very patient, very campy sort of player.
Which makes him the perfect pick for this situation, basically.
Ooh.
Oh, and he gets that F smash.
Wave dash back, forward smash. And again, the Jelly special, the Mario special. If you're playing Mario and you're not wave dashing back, forward smashing,
you
get to doing it. See again. That's 3 times.
Yeah.
He's done it
three times
in a row. He's got to be feeling so confident right now. And Triff is getting more aggressive. He's trying to
good pressure,
get in his face. He realizes what he has to do right now to save Team Spain.
So good, the cape against Peach. Very useful.
All right.
But there goes one stock.
He was very smart. He racked on the damage before the forward throw. Oh, neutral air's out there.
Nair also has a lot of kill potential, which is very much needed against Peach.
Gets him again with these forward air smashes. I do not see Triff finishing this off. He's kind of like, he's fighting on borrowed time right now.
Ooh! That's what everyone wanted to see.
He looks for it again.
I was about to say that's one too much,
yeah.
And he did another one and it worked.
He was like, he knows. And the
great
crowd,
showing there by Jelly.
The crowd is going wild right now. I don't think I've ever heard a Jelly chant that loud. Look at this, Dotorn cancel. All right, and Spain are down to their last man. A man named Scam. He's got 7 stock to take.
This is Scam's chance to become a hero. A hero for Spain.
A hero, a legend.
But the odds are very much against him. With Jelly having 3 stocks left. And also yet another player for England in the back.
Yep. We always have that one more. This nice lead. And he is a Jigglypuff player.
A Jigglypuff.
Right. Okie dokie.
Now...
could be done.
Mario's punishes on missed rests are insane because the cape has no knockback. You can just stack up the percentage.
Is that work in Mario as well? I thought it was just a duck thing. I guess it was the same.
No, Mario can do that as well.
That's cool. So, but if he can get those perfect rests, if he can hit them and get away with them, Puff is the perfect character to try and mount this deficit.
I mean, he's going to have to go for the risky stuff right now, because if he lets Jelly play his patient game, then there's no chance he's going to take this.
Right now, I think Jelly's looking very comfortable. He's looking in control. Those brewskis did him a favor. They're definitely calmed him down. He's feeling himself. Ooh, good forward air. Gets him into a down smash. Ooh. Jelly feeling himself. Oh, no!
That's what I was talking about.
Oh, no.
That is exactly what I was talking about.
Jelly did it in his face. Scam did not want to punish him. And the crowd
it almost looked like he was unsure for a second if the hitbox actually increases with the taunt.
Yeah.
I'm not sure either, actually.
I honestly think he was sitting there thinking this is a trap. Like, this is some sort of trap, man. I think everyone has to prepare themselves. I think we're definitely going to be seeing UK or England, Germany, the old rivals. Alright, but let's see what Scam can do here. Let's see how far he can pull it back, if at all. Ooh. Wave lands into a down smash from the ledge. Jelly just biding his time, picking his moments. Good up smash by the jukebox. Battlefield just a little bit too small to...
Now there's no reason for Jelly to overcommit to anything. He can just play the patient game he's so good at.
He can relax. He knows he doesn't have to force it. Right now he knows there's money in the bank. Ooh, good back air. Back airs right now. There we go. Wade dashes out of his shield into another forward smash.
Those kill really early. Against a light wave float, you like Jigglypuff.
Nope. I think Scam is finding himself a little bit more now, but I just, it doesn't look like he has the skill necessary to pull this deficit. These backers. These backers just walling out this Jigglypuff. Jigglypuff can get away in.
That's all he needs to do. Just rack up the percentage. And then he can go fishing for those F smashes.
F smashes, up smashes, down smashes. Mario smashes hard. He can just eat. He just needs to chill. Keep that stage control.
Like, even a Nair might kill at this percentage.
Alright, can Jigglypuff get this edge guard? Forward smash? No, he does a roll.
I don't think that was intentional.
Nope. I feel like he accidentally buffeted it there. Good forward air. Can I get this edge guard? That's gotta be it.
That's gonna be your stock.
Two stocks to one. Alright, if the Jigs can get a rest right now, then it's interesting. But he has to get this kill.
Really nice wall of pain there, actually, by Scam.
He got it started. He couldn't keep it going. If he can get this stock,
he's playing out of his mind right now. Can he?
Yes.
Ooh, he gets him.
He got it.
Now this has become a lot more interesting. All right,
this is definitely more interesting. All right, who is Team UK sending in? Straight up, Alpha Dash stands up. No nonsense. Ice Climbers Jigglypuff is what is about to happen. This is Alpha Dash is sent in against Tech against France for France as well.
How did he do?
He took a stock, but Tech is on a different level. Different level out here. So I think he's feeling pretty confident. He didn't do too bad. I'm guessing none of the spaces were filling up for the challenge. Guys, head on over to the Geeky Goon Squad Casino. Place those bets. You know right now who you are placing your bets on.
Yo.
We're feeling it. Alpha Dash is not about to choke. I don't know. Do we think Scam can do it? Do you think Scam can do it?
Oh, that's a tough one. I kind of want to see it become a close match.
Yep.
But I would put my money on Alpha Dash for this one. And not only because of the stock lead, but also, I don't know, Alpha Dash does have quite some experience.
Yep.
And this is not the first Jix he's going to play against.
Nope.
This is not even the first Jix he's going to play against today, so.
Nope. He definitely has traveled.
He's in the mode he needs to be in.
I know he was feeling pretty nervous before the match,
cool.
Though, so. He said before the start of the career battle he was feeling a bit nervous, but we'll see where it goes. I think he can do it. Ice Climbers hit hard, and that's what you need to kill Jix. Yeah, hard hit.
Alright. Now, the early game, as I might call it, the low percentage, ooh, is just going to be all about the grabs. And if he gets Ice Climbers to, if he gets the Jigglypuff to a higher percentage, then he's may be going for a lot more of those wave dash smashes. Because if
definitely.
Both of them hit, they have so much kill potential.
Ooh.
Oh, no grab.
Ooh.
There.
No grab. He misses the grab, and now Nana's...
There is one.
Oh.
And
Nana.
The smash by Nana.
Nana.
Doing a really good job there.
Oh. Catches him with the up smash. Doesn't kill off the top. Jigglypuff doing all right. Scam doing all right. He's got one stock. All right, Dijon needs to be careful
for this one.
Needs to be careful right now. He doesn't want to get too smash heavy. He doesn't like to do that with Ice Climbers.
Now, against Sopo, Jigglypuff really shouldn't take any damage.
No, but he gets
said,
the down smash.
He actually loses the stock. This is so crucial.
Ice Climbers down smash so quick and hit so hard, regardless of who's about, whether if Nana's about or not. Scam has got it all to do right now. He's literally got to force stock Alpha Dash for Spain to win this crew battle.
Good job.
3-1. I can feel the crowd. The crowd is a little bit more tense than it was 5 minutes ago. Good forward smash. I think he's just going to try and play it simple. Definitely not seeing any fancy stuff right now. Both players playing very nervy, playing very simple. Just trying to get in, trying to get them big hits.
Well, Alpha Dash doing a good job at racking up that percentage he needs.
He knows.
And
he
now
knows.
He can go for more desynced F smashes, down smashes, up smashes, basically everything that can kill.
Right now he knows all he has to do is rack up percent. He doesn't even need to get that grab. He'd like it. You don't need it. There we go.
There
up
we go
smash.
With that up smash, and UK takes it, or England takes
England
it.
England takes
say.
It off the top.
Hey,
D. There we go. An England advance in this crew bracket. Losers finals
against Oz or Germany.
I think it's Germany. I have no idea what Brado is shouting right now. I literally have no idea. Anyways, we're about to have Germany, England. All right, now this is going to be much tougher. This is going to be much tougher.
I mean, I got to say, Ice is probably not too confident.